Hello students, so today we'll start with the module number 4. The title of the module is point sources and arrays. So in this module we are going to discuss the following topics as follows. So first one is our introduction, so objective of the module and the power theorem and field patterns, then array of two isotropic point sources, then array of n isotropic point sources, the outcomes and important questions in the module. So this is how the flow of this talk with respect to module number 4. The title of the module is what? Point sources and arrays, right? So coming to the introduction part of the module, so as of now antenna is treated as an aperture, like one conductor. So in this chapter it is formally considered as a point source. Means it's a minute part which emits the radiations, which is considered as what? Point. Since it is emits the radiation, it is called point sources. So in this module we are considering this antenna as what? A point source as of now, right? So later the concept is extended to an formation of arrays. Here arrays means so collection of a same kind of point sources. As you discussed in programming language, we are declaring the variables like arrays. The same way, so if you collect the n number of point sources in a single line, or it's a concept of extending the point sources, so it results in what? Array of point sources. It's a collection of same kind of point sources in a line, which is called array of point sources. Then the pattern of any antenna can be regarded as produced by an array of point sources. Now we are analyzing the antenna behavior, so with respect to point sources as well as with respect as array of point sources in this module. So here we discuss the array of confined to an isotropic point sources, which may represent different kind of antennas. So we'll come to the point. What is this point sources actually? Antenna that doesn't have any specified shape is called as point sources. It is our assumption that so one source which emits the radiation is called point source, which can be analyzed by placing that point source in a free space by considering the spherical coordinate. So we'll just have a glance here. We'll consider the point source here. It's an antenna, right? So which is having some surroundings which radiates radiations in that places, or some that particular range. See here, you can observe here the small radius with the A, so bigger radius with the R. In this case, a small radius with the sort B, here bigger radius with the R. So these are the point of observations. Consider an antenna and observation a circle. It's the figure 2.1. So this is the figure. So where the radiated fields of antenna transverse radially, so at the sufficient distance, ID for field, whereas near fields have actual variation ignored, right? Provide that observation made at different distance, any antenna regardless of size or complexity can be represented as a single source. Far field is considered because power flow and fields are radiated outwards at the region properly. So if we consider antenna at observations which radiates the radiations in all the directions, it's called isotropic radiator, right? So you can consider here the field measurements can be done either by fixing the antenna or fixing the observation point, but both effects are approximately same. If in a case of the center of antenna is displaced by distance d as shown in figure, so one, the distance between the two centers are negligible, effect on field pattern at an observation circle provided that, see, this is the condition, R is greater than D, then R is greater than B, as well as R is greater than lambda, where lambda is the wavelength of operation, right? So these are D and B are the small radius of the range of that point sources. This is how, so we are mentioned the range for the points of observation of any point source. So further, We discuss the complete description of far field of a source requires three components. So E theta theta of phi, E phi theta of phi, delta theta of phi. So all these three patterns represents the far field of any point source. So this is a theta component, phi component, and then the delta components, which is the parameters of theta and phi. So these are already discussed in the module 3, basics of antenna parameters, right? Let's move on to the next topic, that is power patterns. What is this power pattern? Let transmitting antenna in free space by point source radiation located at origin of the coordinates. See, let us see here. So point source is placed at the origin and 3D view, right? So this is the phi view, this is the angle theta view, this is the radial view, right? So you can observe here, we have taken one cross section here, this is one cross section, this is one cross section, where exactly they meet at this point. That point is called, say, P. So from origin, if I draw a radial component S, right? So at this point, we have split it into two components. This is E phi, this is E theta. So this is the equatorial plane. So all these we have already discussed in the module 3. So similarly, we will discuss what exactly the main component here. The radiated energy streams from the source radial lines. See, from this is source, which is radiate some radiations to outwards the sphere. So that vector is called S, right? The time rate of energy flow per unit area is a pointing vector or power flow density. The magnitude of pointing vector is equal to the radial component, that is S equal to SR, right? So magnitude, which is S equal to SR. So no signs are here considered. So main important thing is here. So this is a SR is a pointing vector, which is a radial component, right? A source that radiates energy uniformly in all directions is called isotropic antenna. So this is very, very, very important. A source, it's a point source which radiates the energy uniformly in all the directions is called as isotropic antenna, right? So graph of that SR, it's a radial component at constant radius as a function of angle, is a pointing vector or power density, that pattern, but usually is called power pattern, right? So this power pattern can be represented with the help of what? SR, with a constant radius, right? Although the isotropic source is a convenient theory, but it's not a physical realizable type. Even the simplest antenna is a bidirectional properties, that is, radiates energy in some directions than others, right? So in contrast with isotropic antennas, they might be called as anisotropic antenna. So which is antenna or point source which radiates not in all directions. If the antenna or point source radiates in all directions, it is called isotropic antennas, right? But if not in all the directions, it is called anisotropic antennas, or it may be a unidirectional or bidirectional, right? If SR, it's a radial component pointing vector, is expressed in watt per meter square, the absolute power pattern, on the other hand, if it expressed with a reference value, then the graph is called relative power pattern, right? The power pattern is expressed with respect to a relative with the reference to an other value is called what? Relative power pattern. So here SRM is the maximum power in the direction, in particular direction. A pattern with a maximum of unity is called normalized pattern, right? So this is how the power pattern, concept of power pattern, right? So objective of this here is apply the power theorem to solve the problems, analyze the arrays of point sources with their patterns, analyze the different conditions and importance of various types of arrays, right? So let's move on to the important topic of this module here. So power theorem, this is very, very important topic in the most of the exams it has been asked for 8 marks, right? So state and prove the power theorem. So you need to write statements and then you need to write the proof of that, right? It is very important. So if the pointing vector is known as at all the points on the sphere of the radius r from a point source in a lossless medium, the total power radiated by source is integral over the surface of the sphere, the radial component SREF, it is reference, the average pointing vector. Thus, the power is equal to double integral, it is a closed integral, S dot ds, where P is the power radiated in terms of watts, SR is the radial component of average pointing vector, watt per meter square, where ds is the infinitesimal element of an area of a sphere, where ds, difference surface, is given as r square sine theta d phi, the unit is what, meter square. For an isotropic source, sr is independent of theta and phi, right? So can write here P is equal to SR or closed integral, that is ds. Therefore SR is given as P by 4 pi r square. This equation indicates that magnitude of pointing vector varies inversely proportional to the square of distance from the point source indicator. This is the formula to find what power radiated per point sources, where radial vector SR is given as P by 4 pi r square, right? See, then next concept is radiation intensity. It is defined as power radiated by an antenna per unit solid angle. It is denoted by U, and that unit is watt per SR steradians, right? Next, a power theorem for radiation intensity. The total power radiated by an antenna is given by integral of radiation intensity over a solid angle of the sphere. P is equal to again a double integral U d omega, right, where d omega is what, beam area. For an isotropic source, radiation intensity remains same at a point of a surface of the sphere. Let U not be the radiation of an isotropic source, then we can rewrite the above equation as P equal to a double integral, it's a close, so U naught d omega. So we know that d omega is given as sine theta d phi, so replace that. So therefore P equal to U naught is independent of that values. P is equal to U naught integration 0 to pi sine theta d theta and integration 0 to 2 pi d phi. If I integrate this one, so this will become what, P is equal to 2 pi U naught. So if I integrate sine theta, it will be a cos theta, right? So if I apply the limits, right, it will be minus cos pi, minus of minus cos 0. So therefore P is equal to U naught 4 pi. So U naught is equal to P by 4 pi, where U naught is what, radiation intensity. Therefore the relation between the pointing vectors and the radiation intensity as follows. We know that SR is what, radial component. So P by 4 pi r square. So SR into r square. If I take r square here, so here I left out with what, P by 4 pi, right? SR r square. P by 4 pi is what, U naught, that is radiation intensity. You replace here, therefore U naught will be what, SR r square, right? This is a very important relation. So radiation intensity U naught equal to P by 4 pi, then radiation intensity is given by SR r square. So it is a radial vector and it's a radius, right? This is how the relation between the radial component with respect to the power theorem. So most important point here is that examples of power patterns. In that unidirectional cosine pattern, so one more is there, bidirectional cosine pattern. So this is very, very important. So which is given by radiation intensity is given as U equal to Em cos theta. But the angle conditions are here that, so U is given by Um cos theta. So which is lies between when theta lies between 0 to pi by 2 or 0 between pi, 0 or else. So pattern really looks like this. Like it has some components of intensity. So between the angle 0 to pi by 2, here means 0 to pi by 2 or else 0 to pi, 0 to pi means 0 to 180 degree it has some a component, but in all other directions it will be 0. See here, up to 180 degree, 270, up to 360 here no components. So this is called as unidirectional cosine pattern. So remember that if it is a unidirectional components, so theta values will be 0 to pi by 2 or 0 to pi for the any pattern, right, for unidirectional. So one more is that it is a bidirectional cosine pattern. The radiation intensity of unidirectional cosine pattern is given as U equal to Um cos theta and has the value in both the hemisphere. So which is given as U equal to Um cos theta. So at angle condition 0 to what? Pi. Right. Or 0 to pi. So with an phi angle. So 0 or else elsewhere. Right. So it is also known as a groundnut a pattern because its appearance like CL 0 to pi is also there, right? Next 0 to pi, so one more hemisphere, so this will be what a groundnut, right? So one more is there, a unidirectional sine pattern. You can observe here that radiation intensity is given as U equal to Um sin theta when angle is between 0 to pi by 2 or 0 to pi, 0 or else. The maximum radiation intensity at theta equal to pi by 2, right? See here, this is the unidirectional sine pattern, right? So in this way, right hand side. So one more is that it's a bidirectional sine pattern, which is given as radiation intensity is given as U equal to Um sin theta, or angle lies between 0 to pi, right? 0 or else. See here. So this is how the pattern looks like, right? So it is also known as a dot nut, a pattern, and pattern is shown this way, right? So this is how the overall concept of introduction. Today we have discussed what exactly the introduction, so like what exactly the point sources, so objective and power theorem, and so field pattern introduction as well. So we have started with the comparing with the two point sources, how exactly the radiations, outward directions and points under considerations, right? What are the patterns which decides or components which decides the far field, as well as power patterns, how it can be defined, as well as pointing vector, SR, and that is the radial vector. And then we have move on to the what power patterns, then normalized pattern. Then move on to the power theorem, that is P equal double integral, it is SDS, which is results in what SR equal to P by 4 pi R square. So then concept of radiation intensity as well, so which results in what U naught equal to P by 4 pi, that is radiation intensity. Then relation between the SR and radiation intensity, which is given as U naught is equal to SR R square. So this is how the concept of power theorem, right? So rest all the things we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.